Okay, let me introduce myself. My name is Praveen. I'm a part of the executive committee of the Free Software Movement of India. I'm also part of what is called the Forum of IT Professionals. You know, we are a group of people based out of Hyderabad who have been working on the IT retrenchments issue. Now, again, as I said, thank you to the organizers for inviting me, and I'm very happy to be here. So let me start with what is the scenario over here. Now I'll give you a brief introduction to the scenario. In the last 1 year, and I have the statistics for the first three quarters of this financial year. Now we have seen tens of thousands of jobs in the IT sector being lost. Now the headcounts of major companies, including Infosys, Wipro, Tech Mahindra, have decreased. And sequentially, quarter by quarter, their headcounts have decreased. This is for the first time in the Indian IT industry that in sequential quarters, their headcounts have decreased. Now, this has never happened before. Now, they might see in one quarter their headcounts might dip, but they might come up. But this year we are seeing that the headcounts are coming down. Consequently, while the revenues and profits are actually increasing, right? The headcounts are going down, the profits and revenues are increasing, which means people are losing their jobs while the companies are continuing to make increasing revenues and increasing profits. This is at the expense of people's lives. Tech Mahindra is a classic example. For every 5,000 people that are being let go of the company, their profits are increasing by 150 crores, which is almost a direct proportion of the employees and their salaries, or what's euphemistically called cost of services or the cost of revenues in the IT industry. Now, it's not new that people are being retrenched in the IT industry. This has always happened. And if you remember the 2008s, 2009s, when the global recession started, there were people who were being retrenched in the IT industry. It actually happens almost every year under the guise of what we call performance appraisals, or this is an annual review cycle where you're tagged as an underperformer. Okay, you're tagged as an underperformer and you're let go, or one reason or another is always given for people to be retrenched. And the word that is used is a layoff. Okay, now technically or legally speaking, what's actually happening is a retrenchment and not a layoff. But those technicalities aside, until a few years back, until even a year and a half ago, people were not really ready to accept that these are retrenchments in the IT industry. Always people had this perception that it's the performance that's actually the barometer, and people are being let go because their performance was not up to the mark. Even inside your own company, your colleagues or your ex-colleagues were not really ready to come up and stand in solidarity with you. But all of this changed in the last 1 year. Now there are two or three reasons why there is a change in the IT industry, or why people are coming out and protesting, and why people are actually standing in solidarity. It is because, as I just started, the opportunities outside, if you come out of a company and you're looking out for a job, it is not the same as it was, more than a year back. So a year and a half ago, you were still able to, easily find a job if you had decent experience and all of that stuff. Today, the scenario is actually totally the opposite. If you are somebody who has more than 7 years experience, then your chances of moving out of a company and getting a job elsewhere is very, very slim. And if you are somebody who has more than 12, 13 years experience, then it's almost impossible for you to go out of a company and find a job in some other company. As Praveen was also pointing out, there are structural changes that are happening in the industry. There are technological shifts that are happening in the industry. And it's not new. Technology will keep changing. Technology has been changing. But the problem is, if I were a company, how I would look at it is, why hire somebody who has 15 years experience when the technology is new, when I could actually hire somebody with 2 or 3 years experience, because the technology is new for both of them. I would rather pay one third of the salary that I'm paying to, the 15 years experience person, and I would actually, get somebody who is, fresh. There are shifts that are happening, and which means people who have actually 15 years of your worked in industry, it almost means that you've spent the most productive part of your life working for a company, working on a technology. Now, if you're thrown out of that, where is your job? Where is your life? You're actually thrown out of your livelihood. After spending 15 years of my life working on a technology in a company, if I were asked to go out and find a new alternative livelihood, it's almost impossible for me to do that, right? And 15 years of your experience, it also means that your family is in a state where your kids are in education where lots of financial resources need to be put over there, especially given the current scenario. At least in Hyderabad, for example, there are no schools which offer you know, education to your child at less than, you know, 80,000 to 1 lakh per annum, right? And it's probably the same all over India, right? And your parents are dependent on you, your in-laws are dependent on you, your health of your parents and in-laws is also, you know, deteriorating, or, you know, you'll need to put more for your, for the medical expenses and all of that stuff. So this is the scenario today where people are not able to find jobs if you're coming out of the industry. The other problem also is that you're being tagged as an underperformer, right? And you know, this tagging is like a black mark, right? If you're thrown out of a company, now what happens is, what we have seen is, we have been working with hundreds of people, all of them say the same thing. When I apply for an interview, I get a call from the, you know, recruiter or the HR, who asks, where are you currently working? And they say, hey, I currently do not have a job, I'm searching for a job. They say, okay, fine, I'll call you back. Which essentially means it's a dead end for you. Because what it tells is that you're not currently working, which means your previous company has termed you an underperformer. Now, for what reason is this underperformer? It's essentially hogwash, okay? And actually, people don't even realize that, you know, there's no legal precedence in India which says that performance is a parameter that can be used to actually terminate or retrench an employee. Now, Probir was also mentioning another thing. People in IT refuse to believe that we are actually workmen. Okay, I'm using the word workmen because the Industrial Disputes Act uses the word workmen, and we believe that we are all managers. You know, in the IT industry, we have sophisticated terminology to describe us. You're a tech lead, you're a project manager, you're a delivery manager, you're a senior project manager. I don't think there is any other industry which actually has 80% managers or 90% managers, only 10% people who are actually working. So all of this sets a philosophical thought into our mind which says that, oh, we are all managers, we are not workmen. Now, the moment all of this happens, you go to the labor commissioner, and the first thing is, oh, I'm a project manager. And the labor commissioner will just say, okay, you're part of the management, and hence I cannot help you. The first struggle is actually convincing and all the people that we are workmen, irrespective of the fancy titles that we might be given. Everybody has a fancy title, right? Everybody in the software industry, you know, every year you need to show some progress, so you're saying, oh, you're senior project one, manager one to senior project manager two. I don't know, whatever you can come up with. So every year you're given some fancy title. So the first struggle is actually to, you know, help build that notion that we are not part of the management and we are all workmen. The other part is there's a big myth that, you know, labor laws do not apply to IT employees. Almost everybody thinks, including, you know, when we were going to the labor offices, the officers themselves said that, oh, your IT employees and labor laws do not apply to you, or labor laws are exempt for IT companies. In fact, this was partially true. This was partially true in some of the states where there were government orders given stating that, you know, oh, these people are exempt from so and so laws. There was no blanket exemption, but still there were exemptions that were given, which had to be fought back. You know, we had to fight back in the courts, you know, saying that these are constitutional rights and no government can take them away at a diktat, right? Just by passing an executive order, you cannot take away your constitutional right. We had to fight back. We had to, you know, argue in the courts. We had to educate people that, you know, labor laws do apply to, you know, IT employees as well. We are all workmen. And this is still a process of, education. What happens is people, because of the lack of awareness of labor laws, people are, being easily, retrenched. I'll give you a couple of examples of how this retrenchment takes place. In a company, you know, they'll call you and they say, okay, if I'm giving you 5 minutes time and I'll give you the paper, they'll give you a 100 rupee bond paper where everything is already pre-filled with your name and everything, saying that you're voluntarily resigning and you have to sign it within 5 minutes or else you'll be terminated. Now, why would anybody actually sign a 100 rupees, bond paper stating that I'm voluntarily resigning? A resignation, why would it be on a 100 rupee bond paper? And the threat is of a termination. Now, termination is not so easy. If the labor laws have to be followed, there's a lot of procedure that needs to be followed before a person can be terminated. But on the threat of termination, where people are told that, if you're terminated, you will not get a job. This will be a black mark on you. This threat is there, and people are, you know, signing the resignation and coming out all within a matter of 5 to 10 minutes. We have seen companies who have deployed bouncers, medical professionals, psychiatrists who are in the same room where all of this is happening to counsel the employee as to what is the best thing for him. And the best thing for the employee is to actually resign and walk out of the company where they have spent 15 years of their life. And this has happened, and we are fighting that case. Now, Verizon is one of those companies where we are fighting that case where, in Hyderabad, more than 200 people were let go on the same day. When we took them to the courts and when we took them to the labor commissioner, Verizon has the guts to say that, you know, 200 people voluntarily resigned on the same day and we had nothing to do with that. And I don't know what to say to that. You know, we had to take them to task by filing criminal cases against them at the police station. We had to protest against them. We currently have high court cases running against them. This is all new for the IT industry. You know, for the IT industry, for people to come out and actually believe that they are workmen and not managers itself is new. But today, the situation is changing. Today, people are organizing. Today, people are coming out in groups and starting to protest in front of these things. You know, at Tech Mahindra, for example, we had a rally. If I talk about the numbers, it might look small. We had 150 people rally in front of Tech Mahindra in Hyderabad. Though the number might sound small, for an IT company, for people to come out onto the streets and protest, I think it was the first time in Hyderabad that there were people coming out on the streets and protesting, especially on this employee-employee relations. This hasn't happened before. Now, these are the forms of struggle that are building up. Now there are at least 1,500 to 2,000 petitions in front of the Labor Commissioner today from the Forum of IT Professionals side in terms of alleging about the illegal terminations that are happening. What we're also doing is launching massive awareness campaigns. The first thing that is lacking is the awareness. You know, a lot of us actually think that, as we discussed, these labor laws do not apply. So we are launching awareness campaigns. Yes, we have to use Twitter, we use pamphlets. We go out onto the streets and actually distribute pamphlets. And there are our experiences. When we did this a year and a half ago, people refused to even take a pamphlet. But today, people are coming out asking for pamphlets. They're taking them. They're distributing to their friends and colleagues. Now, this has actually started to pick up. Now, in fact, if you see, 3 days back, Cognizant, there was a report in the Hindu which said that, Cognizant is shifting 8,000 jobs from India to the US. Right? There are multiple reasons to why these are happening. One is the tighter H-1B norms, also outsourcing being not so lucrative anymore for the US-based companies. Right? I know they can go to the Philippines, they can go to Indonesia, they can go to other countries, which are also offering these outsourced services at lower cost. But all of these things are happening, and Cognizant employees are not remaining calm and silent. Now they are reaching out. They're trying to do things proactively. They're trying to preempt these situations where they can fight back. And today, there's a good chance that, we will be able to fight back and win. In fact, we have had our successful victories as well. In Wipro, for example, when we were organizing, when we were fighting back, Wipro management had to step down and take back employees. People who were forced to resign, people who were under the threat of, termination. We fought Wipro's management, and people had to be taken back. We are doing the same thing at Tech Mahindra. We are actually fighting, against companies which are owned by people like Warren Buffett and all of this stuff. So I think the resistance has started. People are starting to fight back. People are coming out onto the roads. People are coming out onto the streets and protesting, which did not happen a year and a half back. But the situation is not going to be different. March and April are the months where IT industry typically goes through, as what I said, the performance appraisals, which means the IT companies are setting themselves up for large-scale retrenchments again. This is the time that we all stand up and actually fight back. And the time has come, and we are doing that. Thank you.